Blessed is the man who will believe.
He is the reason.
Yes.
That we gather together today.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
He is the reason for the season.
Yes, he is.
We're not here to catch up on the latest gossip.
That's right.
We're here to worship God.
Yes.
Around our church and our membership.
Amen.
We're here to worship God.
Yes.
We're not here to brag and boast about our own self-righteousness.
That's right.
We're here to worship God.
Yes, we are. Amen.
We're not here to dispense helpful household hints. We're here to worship God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. First, we must understand that God does not accept substitutes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Amen.
Yes, the text here is a continuation of his previous indictment against the priests and the believers of the Hebrews.
Yeah.
God has begun the process of shifting his attention from the Hebrews, which were at that time his chosen people. His attention from them to the Gentiles. God is saying that he has visited their worship. I don't know about you, church, but it's something about you don't have to be in the midst of a crowd to really worship and praise God.
Amen.
You don't have to be in the midst of a 9 or 10 or 20 or 100 to praise God.
That's right.
I find more praises in my own spirit just walking around.
Amen.
In my own house.
Amen.
In my own car. Right. By myself sometimes.
Amen.
I find more praises than that.
Amen.
And knowing that God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
God said that no man who comes to the worship setting ought to have enough sense to know that he's stepping into just any place.
Yes.
This is the house of God, where we are now.
Amen.
Have you noticed that this place is different from any other place you go into?
Amen.
This is not your house.
That's right.
Amen.
This is not your doctor's office.
Yes.
Praise God.
This is not your apartment complex.
Amen.
This is not your sports arena.
Yes.
Amen.
This is not your movie house.
Amen.
This is not your community center, but this is the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You should think that the standard of the house would indicate that you come up to the house of the Lord.
Yes.
And as Peter and John, they went up to the temple.
Amen.
We should never use the phrase, I'm going down to the church, but I'm going up to the church.
Yes.
Hallelujah, somebody. The standards are higher here.
Thank you, Lord.
The praise is higher here. The fellowship is higher here.
Yes.
The requirements are higher here.
Yes.
The presence of God is here.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
When I come to the house of the Lord, praise the Lord, I need to understand that there are other places I could go.
Amen.
That have other requirements.
That's right.
But when I come to the house of the Lord, I ought to come with the praise in my mouth.
Yes.
I ought to come not waiting to see what the pastor's going to preach about.
Amen.
But I ought to come already with the praise of thanksgiving and love and concern for the Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
I just can't go to a concert and start singing James Brown songs because I like them better there and other people who want to hear them.
Amen.
I just can't start talking loud in the library.
All right.
Amen.
And pull out my boom box and start playing loud music because I want to do that.
That's right.
But when some of us come to the place of the house of God, we take spiritual shortcuts and we let me tell you, the older I'm getting, the more I'm fearful of our conduct.
Hallelujah.
We say anything in the house of God.
Amen.
We talk about anything in the house of God, but this is a house of prayer.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about you, but I've seen some nasty attitudes this year in this house.
Thank you.
I've heard some conversations, or should I say overheard some conversations in this house that God has frowned on.
Yeah.
That God is not pleased with in this house.
Amen.
But I'm here to set the record straight.
Thank you.
No more of that in this house.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Oh, I'm not going to win.
Thank you, Lord.
Popularity this month.
Preach, preach.
I was running for office like the presidents and others are running on next year. I would say that I better get out of the race because I have no chance of winning with some of you.
Hallelujah.
But see, I'm not serving you. I'm serving God.
Hallelujah. right.
Amen. There used to be a day when we didn't write on an offering envelope, which I get all the time, once writing on in the sanctuary.
Amen.
There used to be a day when we didn't parade in church.
That's right.
We sat down and we stayed in our seat until the benediction was given.
Amen.
There used to be a day when people shouted at devotion.
Amen.
There used to be a day when people said amen during the sermon.
That's right.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
There used to be a day when people clapped if the choir could sing or not.
Amen.
They clapped anyway because they knew that's where the presence of God was.
Amen.
God says that they were bringing to him sacrifices that were impure. And God says, you are cursed because of that.
Amen.
You are cursed because you tried to take a shortcut.
Uh-huh. Amen.
You are cursed because you tried to slip one in on God.
That's
you are cursed because you wrote a $100 check on an envelope and you put $20 in.
Amen.
You are cursed because you wrote a mini tie using a pen that would cost more than your Bible.
Yes.
Praise God.
Amen.
God says, you promised me that you would bring to me a healthy male ram to put on the altar.
That's right.
You decided to do it, and that's okay, but a donkey was put there instead.
Amen.
You put a stick one on the altar and said no one saw you, that it's okay.
Amen.
But it's not okay.
Yes.
God says you sinned privately, but I'm going to publicly curse you.
Amen.
Secondly, God says, you've forgotten what I've been in your life.
Amen.
It's interesting to note that when God has to remind us and say, wait a minute, it's even more interesting to note that God has to tell his people who he really is.
That's right.
Yes.
Do you know who he is?
Amen.
Do you know him as being a lying fisher?
Yes.
Being a heart regulator?
Yes. Thank you,
Jesus. Do you know him as being a doctor?
Hallelujah.
And a sick woman, a lawyer? And
yes.
A courtroom?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
This suggests that when you take shortcuts after shortcut and cut corners after cutting corners, you become numb to why you are really serving God.
Uh-huh. Amen.
In the first place, and then you become numb as to who God is.
That's right.
I have to admit, sometimes you can be so busy serving God that you may forget who God really is.
That's right.
You can be so busy trying to get to meetings and trying to get to rehearsals and trying to get to the usher board meeting and trying to get to Sunday school and trying to get here and there. Praise
yes.
the Lord. And trying to get to church.
Praise
and trying
Lord.
To get to all of these places that you start serving the
yes.
church and stop serving God.
Amen.